Hi everyone, this is Tabib Ikram, hosting from Algerian Youth Voices, Wurgla. We saw this story with what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said. Teach your children swimming, archery and horse riding. Follow our reporter Abdul Baqi bin Ashura.
In this hadith, the Prophet Muhammad emphasized the importance of swimming, and our topic in this story is about it. This time, the hero is Yusuf Tahmi, who kept standing despite all what he passed through.
I was suffering from asthma, and that's what led me to make a surgery inside my nose and my throat. And after this, the doctors advised me to go for swimming 3 times a week to be able to breathe naturally. And this is the beginning of my story.
After 3 successive years of practicing swimming, Yusuf found himself that he became good at this sport, and that's what made him to think of joining to a swimming club. But indeed, he did. He became a member of Wurgla Swimming Club. It's known as the PSO.
It's a French word. It means Piscine Semi-Olympique.
As a member of PSO club, Yusuf went through competition experiences. He started at the regional competitions.
In my first participation in regional competition, I was in the first rank, and this is what attracted the attention of my coach. The swimmers of the first rank were in the spotlight, in which we have been involved in massive daily training to be prepared to all kinds of competitions.
After taking many regional competitions, he was qualified to the national ones.
In 2006, exactly, in the national championship in Skikda, where I participated in. I was in 28th rank among 289 swimmers from all of the country.
Something bad happened in this competition. Yusuf had to be in the second national team.
But I was replaced by another swimmer from another team here in Algeria, from the Mouloudia exactly, who chosen by corruption exactly. When I tried to get my right back, the club administration told me, sorry, we can't do anything for you.
In 2008, in Oran Open National Championship, where Yusuf participated and attracted the attention of IASMA coach, in which IASMA team was the best team in Algeria at that time.
The coach came and said to me that I have a unique technique, breaststroke. Then he talked with my coach. He suggested to him that if I passed my BOM exam, I had better to pursue my study in athletic high school at Draria. Then they will transfer me to IASMA club. But my father refused this offer, arguing that I will fail in my study, as well as the club administration refused to transfer me.
In 2009, in the National Cup Championship, Yusuf and his team got the 8th class among 48 club. But there were some problems in the same year, which led the PSL coach decline his retirement.
You know that I passed through very hard period in that time. After 1 year, we returned to water. Not as swimming team, but as a water polo team. We were happy and sad in the same time. We were happy because we returned to water. We were sad because we love swimming, not the water polo.
They failed as water polo team.
We were participated in 2 competitions. We lost all the matches and because of lack of training and great disappointment of that game.
And what made it worse is that Yusuf and his mates discovered something very dangerous.
By time, we discovered that the swimming pool administration were exploiting and using us for making money because they were receiving budget from the government. Then some problems have happened and we all quitted the team.
After all what happened, Yusuf could not bear being far off water. He decided to return to swimming, but this time, as a coach, not as a swimmer.
In 2013, I returned to swimming, but as a coach of little categories in the same swimming pool. Since that time, I'm coaching the children because I want to give my experience and all my skills, and I'm so happy with them. despite all what happened, the experience that I had, I'm still young and I'm just 21 years old.
Thank you for listening. I hope you have enjoyed the story. Please follow us on our page, Algerian Youth Voices. Goodbye.